the last day of BookTubeathon, and I'm here today to do the Day 7 video challenge, story time. Today's challenge is hosted by Ariel from the channel Ariel Bassett, and as usual, I'll leave a link to her video down below in my description. So this challenge is basically just about talking about a book that means a lot to you, and as soon as I saw Ariel's announcement video, I immediately thought of The Hunger Games. Okay, maybe you guys are getting tired of me talking so much about The Hunger Games, but I just couldn't think of any other book that would be appropriate for this challenge. So now I'm going to share with you my Hunger Games story. I wasn't one of these girls that was a fan of The Hunger Games as soon as the books got published, because I only started to read the books when they were all already out. They even were out already in German, so the first book got released here in Germany in 2012, and I started to read the books in 2013. My Hunger Games story kind of began when my mom was looking for a Christmas present for me. So she went to the bookstore, and the first Hunger Games book had just been released in German and was super hyped here, so of course the bookseller told my mom about this book. But when my mom read the text on the back of the book and realized that it was about kids being forced to murder each other, she thought, no, no way, that's nothing my little girl would read, and she came home with another book. So then when I unwrapped my Christmas presents and I was super happy about this other book, I don't remember what it was exactly, it doesn't matter now. My mom also told me about The Hunger Games and she asked me if I had heard of it. I hadn't. And she told me what it was about, and I was glad that she didn't buy it because it was not something that I would have read at this point. So I then forgot about it again. But about a year later, when the first Hunger Games movie was about to be released in theaters, the whole internet was full of trailers and everything. And via YouTube, I kind of came back to The Hunger Games, and I thought, okay, there has to be something about these books that everyone seems to love them so much. So I googled what it was about again, and I read some reviews, and I really made sure that it wouldn't be too brutal for me. And then I thought I had to give this book a chance. So I went to the library and picked the first book up. I still remember how I felt when I started to read this book. I went into it with mixed feelings, I was even a little scared, and then I finished it in 2 days because I couldn't stop reading. It was so amazing. I loved it so much. So I went to the library again and got Catching Fire at Mockingjay, and I read the entire trilogy in just a week because I was so engaged in the story. I just couldn't stop reading. Oh my god, I'd never expected to love these books so much. Half a year later, I was still thinking about these books and I thought that I wanted to read the first book again, but this time in English. So I bought my first copy of The Hunger Games. It's this one. I bought it on the internet, and it is the movie tie-in. It was the cheapest one that I could find. It was the first book that I had ever bought in English just for myself, not something that I had to read for school, but I bought it because I wanted to read it. And I read it so many times, I accidentally once even sat on it. That is why this is here. but I also think that this is how a beloved book should look like. I then read it again, and I remember sitting in the garden and tearing up at some scenes and all the emotions hitting me so hard, and I just couldn't stop thinking about this book. So by this time the movie had come out, but I wasn't a big fan of going to the cinema when I was younger, so I didn't watch it on the big screen. And about half a year later the movie was on TV for the first time, so I watched it together with a good friend who had also read the books but hadn't seen the movie by now. And we were positively surprised by the movie. I had never expected to like it. So when Catching Fire came out in theaters, I really wanted to see it. And everyone kept telling me how amazing it would be on the big screen. Even my piano teacher told me that I had to see it in theaters. So I asked all my friends, and one of my friends had already seen Catching Fire in the theater, but she liked it so much that she said she would watch it again with me. And I was super nervous because it was the first movie I watched in theaters for a long time, and then I was absolutely mind blown. There is no other word for this. I came home from the movie and I couldn't stop thinking about it. I then reread Catching Fire at Mockingjay, also in English, and I grew more and more attached to these books. I googled fan theories and everything. I couldn't stop thinking about this trilogy. So, yeah. Honestly, I owe so much to these books. They introduced me to young adult literature. It was also the first dystopian novel that I read, which is now my all-time favorite genre. They also made me laugh watching movies in the theater again, because if I hadn't read the books, I would have never gone and seen Catching Fire, of course. I became interested in archery. I started to write my own fan fictions. It even made me become interested in politics because I started comparing Panem to our world. I began to see the parallels, and that was super scary, and I was just so engaged and I couldn't stop thinking about it, and I think I also couldn't stop talking about it, and I think that my friends and family are already tired of me talking about the series. So I'm super glad that this challenge for today gave me the reason to gush about my favorite book, because I kind of can't do it in real life anymore. So this was my Hunger Games story. This may be my favorite trilogy for all time. This is a book that really changed my life. So I was happy to share my story with you guys. And maybe you also have a book that kind of changed your life, then please let me know down below in the comments. I would love to hear about your book stories. I hope you enjoyed mine, and see you next time.